Your opponent should be able to capture one of your pawns and wipe the rest of the board. That's an interesting theory. Okay. So here we got a reversed Slav thing. White should just play knight bd2. But white gets fancy. White gets so fancy. Okay. Really? Why would you... I don't understand. Why would you take that? That just seems incredibly risky and dangerous. You'd only take that if you had no idea, like, of what risks and dangers were involved. Because you don't even gain that much for having taken on d5. How come I don't have a winning move here? I want to just win the game on the spot. Instead, I'm forced to play good moves. Okay, so here we are. We've got a bishop, he's got a knight. Aren't bishop versus knight middle games exciting? I don't know, maybe they are. So I want to develop somehow. We've still got a bishop versus knight dynamic going on. My opponent keeps insisting that trades help him. I'm not entirely convinced that he's correct in that point of view. Wait, if I take the knight, queen takes, wait, no, if I take c1, then we get an opposite color bishop endgame. So I should be able to draw that. Oh, and I'm playing Fianchetto here. I didn't even glance at my opponent's name until just then. Okay. Yep, so this should be drawish. I don't know. I'm just a little bit tired here. Just a little bit. Let's see. I have to count this accurately. I'm bored. So because I'm bored, I'm going to play this. There we go. Woo! What a game. What a game. Okay. But yeah, to Fianchetto's point, people always get good positions against me and then get annoyed when they can't convert them instantly. There's one slight flaw in that reasoning, and the flaw is this. Some people actually enjoy playing endgames. How did I swindle that? I swindled it because I enjoy endgames. That's how.